To swage these fasteners on the ends of the cables, you need a hydraulic crimper or something that can apply a lot of force to crimp these. And what I've seen people doing is using actually two crimps, one crimp about here, one crimp here. So two crimps to crimp the cable and make sure it's secure. I saw some recommendations of using the Harbor Freight hydraulic crimper. I was looking for something that was a tiny bit better quality. Found this. And also when I was looking at it, something that was interesting is that some of them had, it was hard to tell from the pictures, but and how it worked, there was no explanation. Some of them had straight shafts on the inserts. And this one had a little groove leading me to believe that there was some kind of ball lock or some kind of lock that would lock it in there. Because some people complain about other designs that they would just put them in there and they just fall out and they'd have to keep them in there. This is my first experience with such a tool, so I do not know whether other tools have something similar, but the fact that their shafts are straight with no groove leads me to think that they may not have anything to hold them in, and based on the reviews, some of the reviews I've seen. So instruction manual, looks like there's spare O-rings in case that you need to probably to rebuild the oil cylinder, and it shows you how everything goes together. So you might need to, I need to look into like what causes the oil cylinder to need to be rebuilt. And I think you just need to be careful about not over pressurizing. Like once the dies meet together, you don't want to keep compressing it. It was wrapped in this plastic bag. I already taken it out of there. So the dies are held in place, and you'll see they snap out. This one, I need to retract the piston all the way. Okay. So the dies do snap out. They do have a groove. There's a little, if you look down in there, you can see there's a little ball bearing that holds it in place, snaps and locks it in place. Same thing with the top. There's a little bearing there too. From in here, you can see the hole for the set screw that holds the bearing and spring in there. And same thing, it's pretty secure. So it stays in by itself. It's not like super aligned together, but probably good enough. And the whole head swivels too, so you can swivel to any convenient orientation. There were some that were being sold, same design, but they were selling them with only like maybe two dies specifically for crimping their own brand or other brands of these cable ends. I wanted something, since I figured I could use this for other electrical terminals, I wanted something that had more dies available with it, because it doesn't seem, I don't see any way to buy the dies just by themselves. So I plan to use this for electrical terminals also. I could have definitely used it in the past. And all these dies have the little grooves on them to hold them in place. So we need to find the right, since there's no real indication as to what the right size die is, we need to find the correct size die for this. And so that might take a little bit of experimentation. So the 12 is definitely not right. I think it's going to be, okay, the 4 is too big. Yeah, I would guess the 6. So the 4 was touching, the 4 gauge was touching, and the 6 is not. So that's the only other size that's here. So let's show the 4 gauge. The 4 gauge is like basically the dies are touching together. So be the next gauge up, next gauge smaller, which is the 6. And that looks like there's plenty of space to compress, maybe too much. I'm not sure. We'll see. once we start actually doing it on the cable. Now I was curious to see what's under here, under this handle, and it looks like it's just pretty much hollow, and there's just the oil reservoir, which is a soft, squishy rubber body, and has a screw-on thread. So I assume if you unscrew that, it's going to dump the oil, and you can replace the oil. So the actual cylinder body is really very small in here, and the instructions, I guess, show how to take it apart to replace any parts necessary to replace. So let me go ahead and put those six inside here. So it's ready. Crimping with this hydraulic hand crimper is doable. Crimping these ends on, it can be done, but these ends are, they're pretty thick stainless. So it takes a lot of force to get through that. And honestly, I would have gone with a larger, stronger tool, the one that the dies are captured on both sides. It's not a C shape. It's closed in on both sides and has a pin, and it has longer handles for more leverage, so you can apply more force. This is something like a 5-ton one. Some of them advertise up to 8 to 10 tons, but I don't think that's probably true. They're probably all the same in this size, and the bigger ones advertise like 16 tons. I can see the necessity for more force. I don't really want to buy another one, because the problem is with the 16 tons is that the dies don't come, I think, in 8 gauge. Here I'm using 8 gauge. I think the smallest dies there are like 6 gauge. So then you need to buy an extra set of die that fits those. And there's some, if you look in the description down below, like I have a list of that stuff that you can buy. This modification I've created actually works pretty well. So what I do is I just slide this in here, and then I slide this handle onto here. What I noticed here too is that this end pieces, these swage ball ends, they call them, are a lot bigger diameter, a lot more metal there than these screw-in ones, these threaded ones. So it's gonna take more force to crimp down on these. When you're using this crimper to do the crimps, it really, like at the end of the stroke, to get that last little bit of crimping, I mean, it really takes, like, you just gotta put all your force into it that you can. And I'm pretty strong. I can put a lot of force into stuff. A lot of times I tighten knobs and caps and stuff like that. Other people can't take it off. So I know that I have enough strength to do this. But after a while of doing this, it really starts to hurt your hands. And so what I wanted to do is make something where it requires a little bit less force, and it's just easier to do, and I don't have to be pushing quite so hard. So I screwed a pipe. This is just actually chain link fence pipe. I screwed that using 2 screws into a board, just left a lot enough space for the handle to go in there, and then slide another piece over that's got some foam inside of it. This handle gives some extra leverage on here. Where I just, you have to be careful, because you can put more force into the jaws of this crimper than the crimper can handle. You can probably blow the head off or blow the seals in there pretty easily. So you got to be careful not to, like, you don't want to be struggling on this. You want to observe when it looks like it's crimped enough, then to back off. And you can test it too by grabbing here in the original position and seeing like where your force limit is, and then just feeling where that is on with this handle. But this handle makes it so much easier. You're not hurting your hands trying to crimp it really well. So for these end pieces, since mine are going into wood, I am going to put a washer, a stainless washer on the end. That is, it looks nice when it's in the wood, you know, with that stainless washer. It's just going to keep this head from digging in, because I think this head is just going to dig into the wood, and it's going to be uneven. Some of them are going to be sticking out. Some of them are going to be digging in without the washer. And so with the washer, we'll keep everything more even. Let's see how these crimp with this crimper. See how deep the cable goes in. Probably about a half inch from the end. I put this washer over here, and then put the cable inside. And then put it inside the jaws. First I crimp near the end, near the opening. These actually, even though the wall thickness is thicker on these pieces, it actually crimps pretty well. So, and then turn it 90 degrees for the next crimp. Leave about maybe like 3 millimeters of space, and then crimp again. There we go. That's a pretty solid crimp on there.